Hello mga ka-Arki! Welcome to this special video series of Wealth Arki entitled Global Investing for the Filipino Investor, which is done in partnership with AXA Philippines. Kasama natin dito sa video series na to si Mr. Dexter Agkawili, who is the Investment Solutions Director of AXA Philippines and the country representative to Arkitas Asia, an asset management company of the AXA Group. Check out the video description for the links to all the 5 episodes of this video series. That's it for my intro. Let's begin. Hello everyone! Kamusta kayo?
Hello!
And welcome sa episode 3 nitong ating special video series. So of course, kasama pa rin natin si Renzi at saka si Dexter. Alright, kamusta kayo?
Eto, okay naman. Nagmo-monitor ng local stock market. And not just local, global markets din. Sabi nga natin, oh, there's a bigger world out there.
Yan. Oh.
Yeah, mas exciting yan na yan eh. Okay naman so far. Again, tulad ni Renzi, pinagmamasda ng mga pangyayari both local and global.
And, exciting ba?
Exciting. Never a boring day, no? Dahil marami kinakailangan bantayan eh.
Lalo lang ngayon, no? Very challenging times. So for this episode, ang pag-usapan natin ay choosing the right investments, particularly pag mag-i-invest ka both in local and in global markets. Kasi sabi nga natin, there's a bigger world out there. Sabi ni Renzi, di ba? From pond to the goodbye ocean. Pond, hello ocean. So baka naman kasi ma-analysis paralysis ka. Kasi yan yung usual na napapansin ko eh sa mga gusto mag-invest na sobrang dami ng choices. Eh, nag-online shopping na lang kasi nalito. So, for today, hopefully, yeah, we will be able to help yung mga ka-Arki natin kung paano ba pipili ng tamang investment, especially if they want to invest in the global markets.
Okay, tama. Yeah. Saka bukod po dun, Fitz, nadagdag ko lang, madalas kung nakikita sa mga forum, sa mga social media posts, kunwari, okay ba to? Kunwari, blank product, okay ba to? So, kumbaga, parating yung tanong eh, kung okay ba to? Okay ba mag-invest dito? So, I think this topic is very timely and relevant na, kumbaga, if yung mga ka-Arki natin and sa mga viewers natin, if they sit down with this topic, malalaman nila kung okay ba tong investment na to na i-share sa atin ni Dexter. Yun, paano natin malalaman yung choosing the right investment kung okay ba to?
Oo, okay kasi oo, diba? yung mga ka-Arki natin, 'di ba? Lagi tayong tinatanong kung ano yung your thoughts on a particular fund or a particular stock. And I believe na mas maganda kung marunong tayong mag self-assessment ng mga investment, that will be better. Kasi kapag nagtanong tayo ng opinion sa ibang tao, iba yung perspective nila minsan. Katulad ng sinabi mo, Renzi, di ba? Kapag tinanong mo ang isang real estate investor kung ano ang best investment, real estate ang sasagot niya. Kapag stock market trader, stock market, di ba? So, syempre, we cannot blame them for giving that answer because yung experience nila, yung situation nila, yun yung nagsasabi na yun yung magandang investment. So, it means na if we want to look for the best investment for ourselves, then we have to know kung paano ba i-assess yung sarili nating situation.
Yes. Ang usual yung sagot ba natin, ano, pag tinanong tayo?
Depende.
It depends.
Depende.
It depends.
Tanong ko talaga depende. Kasi, kunwari, tatanungin, kunwari, stock market, okay ba tong equity fund na to? Ganyan. So, ang sagot ko dyan, depende. Kasi, baka mamaya, ilalagay mo dyan, kailangan mo next year. Eh, hindi siya okay, di ba? Kung kailangan mo pang next year, lalo na kung pambayad mo ng tuition fee. Pero kung the same fund or the same stock market or stock issue, pero kung sabihin mo na pang retirement, then most probably sasabihin ko na okay yan, di ba?
Mm-hmm. Tsaka minsan magtatanong sila, hindi natin alam, ano nga bang meron ka?
Exactly.
Kailangan malaman muna natin yan.
Oo, that's right.
So, yun yung isa sa mga goal natin for this episode, to give our viewers a framework to work on in choosing the best investment for them. And dalawa yung main questions na sasagutin natin for this episode. Unang-una is where to invest based on your risk profile. And then number two is how much should you invest, which is basically a discussion of asset allocation.
Asset allocation.
Yes. Mm-hmm. So siguro simulan na natin dun sa where to invest based on your risk profile. Can you explain, Dexter, ano ba tong risk profile?
Risk profiling.
Why is it important to know? Yeah.
Well, unang-una talaga kinakailangan, alamin muna natin yung sarili natin kung ano yung capacity natin or kapasidad natin to take certain risk. Diba? Dahil each person would have his own profile, his own risk profile as well, or appetite for risk. So, risk profiling, bahagi yan ng ano, ng pamamaraan natin na magtatanong tayo. Tatanungin natin sarili natin, how long ka ba mag-i-invest or ano ba yung objective mo? May mga series of questions yan. Different banks and different institutions would have like a questionnaire usually to assess ang ating risk profile. Kasi, broadly speaking, kapag pinag-usapan natin risk profile, pwedeng conservative ka or pwedeng nandun ka naman sa other side, which is aggressive ka. Yan. Mm. So, and those kinds of, and merong mga in-between. Kumbaga, graduated yan, no? May mga
spectrum.
May spectrum ka. Yeah, minsan nga, maraming from 1 to 5 na spectrum mo, 1 to 7 or 1 to 10. Pero whatever, yung 1 to whatever na yan is meron kang spectrum na kung from conservative to aggressive. And each of those levels, meron or profiles, merong angkop or appropriate mix of assets. May it be bonds, cash, stocks, or even other kinds of investments or alternative investments. Or pwedeng both local and even global kinds of investments.
Ito yung usual na sinasabi natin na principle of matching, eh, di ba?
Oo. Kasama din dyan yung principle of matching na, ano ba yun? Na imamatch mo eh, na kung yung goals mo, no, and pag-usapan din natin yon on later videos, yung goals mo dapat nakamatch kung kailan mo kailangan yung pera. Like, for example, kapag yung goal mo within the short term, dapat nasa short term instrument or investment ka lang, no? Pag medium term, more of, ano yan, balanced portfolio, may stocks and bonds, which corresponds sa moderate na risk profile, dapat medium term ang horizon mo dyan. Siguro mga 5 to 10 years. Pero pag long term, dapat 10 years or more. So, mas ano ka na dyan, mas aggressive ka na dyan. Kasi you have ano eh, you have more time by your side. So, ano na yan, mga stock market, or even yan yung mga not just local stock market but ano no but even global funds as well. Pero Dex, dun sa risk profile, ano ba to? 'Di ba pag nag-fill up ka online ng risk profile, pwede ba ano, pwede ba na kunari, halimbawa ako no, nagkuha ako dati ng isang policy, ganyan. Tapos di nag-risk profile ako, ang lumabas sa akin is conservative.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But during that time, nung ewan ko lang if you would agree, no? Pero during that time, I was 30 years old. Mga 1 year ago lang yun.
Sira ka tayong orasan mo, kaya nagpalit ka naman ng kalendaryo.
Tuwing leap year lang yata, so nag-celebrate ng birthday.
Okay.
So, during that time, so lumabas. Tapos sinabi nung sales executive sa akin, sir, given this, dapat ano po kayo? Ito po yung mix, 50% na, or moderately ata, basta dapat 50% bond, saka 50% stock market. Pero sinabi ko sa kanya, you know what? I'm 30 years old, sabi ko sa kanya. And maski ganito yung risk profile ko, I'm earmarking this particular policy, yung unit link, no, or VUL, for my eventual retirement, para pambayad ng estate ko when I retire, etc., etc. So my time horizon there is really long term. So sabi ko sa kanya, don't put it there. Sabi ko, lagay mo sa index yan, index tracking. Anong tingin mo doon?
Well, napaka-rich nung statement mo dahil ang daming aspeto doon. Unang-una is yung horizon, di ba? Yung sinasabi mo horizon, tapos also yung circumstances mo at that point in time. Kasi pwedeng iba yung profile mo ngayon as compared nung 30 years old ka, di ba? May mga pagbabago sa buhay mo. Yan, nagkaroon ka ng asawa, anak, as in, it changes your priorities and also your needs through time, no? So there's one that's another dimension when it comes to risk profiling. And if I may share, no, so na mention mo time horizon, the purpose of it, there's what we call a certain framework, this is what I call the hero's approach.
Bago yan, ha?
Heroes.
Parang ano, ha? Parang series lang, ha?
Oh, parang series lang ng mga ano, early 2000, di ba? So, heroes, this is what we do in assessing your profile. One is, we look at the horizon. What horizon are you looking at? Yun. And then, we also assess your experience, your financial or investment experience para mag-gauge namin yung degree of sophistication mo. Tapos, R naman would be for, let's say, your risk appetite. So, may certain questions para ma-assess, kakayanin mo bang sigmurain ng isang decline, let's say, 20% drop sa portfolio mo. Yun. Tapos, also R. Tapos, O naman would be objective. Ano ba yung objective or objectives mo in the next 3, 5, or 10 years? Yeah. And then E would be ito, expected returns. Yes, we would still ask that. Dahil usually, di ba may disconnect between yung appetite. Conservative ako, pero gusto ko 10%.
May mga ganyan, Ayaw sumugal, di ba? Parang, naku, risky yan. Pero pag binigyan mo ng, pag yung return, mga nasa 3-4%, magre-reklamo naman, di ba?
Oo. Diba? Mas mainam na sa simula pa lang as you're assessing, ma-manage na yung expectations sa ganyan. Conservative ka, dapat hindi naman expecting too much. Tapos, nasa na pa ako? E, expected return. S, situation. Situation mo ngayon. Dahil, ano nga ba yung sitwasyon mo? Kasi naman, baka gusto mo nga mag-plan out for your retirement, kaso ang laki pala ng utang mo, hindi mo pa nababayaran sa credit card. Diba? So, part ng financial planning is that assess it properly based on your current situation and then how you want to get to a certain level at a certain point in time. Yun. So, that's what we do, the hero's approach when it comes to assessing your risk profile. Tapos yan na, magsisimula na yung discussion to create your financial plan. Paano yung circumstance ko ngayon? Tapos biglang after some time, magbabago. And pwede ba ako mag-allocate? Kung ang purpose ko for that particular policy is for retirement. Of course, pwedeng you have a certain allocation that na tipong more equities. Pero we should not lose perspective also na how will your total portfolio look like now and then how it will evolve through time.
Yung pag-allocate.
Different aspects.
That's right. Maganda Dex yung heroes, no? Kasi parang a lot of investment discussions and conversations ang pinag-uusapan ng risk appetite. Pag conservative ka, you know, ganun lang. But I like yung heroes approach, no? Kasi parang mas binibigay, it gives more depth on the discussion. Parang 360 degree approach.
So, napaka-importante talaga na meron kang ganitong klaseng assessment. Kasi yung mga iba, pag naghahanap ng investment, ang tanong lang is, ano yung pinakamalaki yung return eh, di ba?
Ano yung pinaka the best?
Oo, pinaka the best. So, as we've learned, maraming factors na kailangan i-consider, katulad nga nung heroes na framework na napaka-comprehensive naman para sa akin, gusto ko siya. And aside from knowing yung risk profile mo, ang next na importante din na i-consider is magkano ba ang i-invest mo? Mm-hmm. So, after mo malaman na, okay, ito yung aking risk profile, ito yung risk capacity ko, ito yung risk required ko, ano ba, lahat ba ng pera ko ilalagay ko dyan? Diba? So, let's talk more about asset allocation. How do you properly divide yung available investment fund or resources mo sa mga iba't ibang klaseng investment?
So first all of all, in ba? Siguro, all in?
Oo,
all diba? In ba, Dexter? Di ba mga ganyan, di ba? All in na daw ng market. All in, di ba? Kundi lang all in, meron pa yung mga revenge portfolio.
Yes.
Ay, nako.
Okay, so siguro, let's first define, ano ba yung meaning ng asset allocation at saka ano ba yung importance ng pagkakaroon ng isang magandang portfolio, yung we manage a portfolio. So, siguro si Dexter, tanongin natin. Ano ba yung concept of
favorite, asset allocation? Favorite niya yung asset allocation na yan eh.
Gano'n ba?
Well, sa totoo lang, favorite ko yan dahil, well, one, empirically, proven naman that yung returns sa portfolio
naman,
mo.
Empirically.
Empirically. Based on studies, yeah, based on studies, di ba? Yung resulta ng returns ng portfolio mo or performance, investment performance ng portfolio mo, ang nagde-determine yan or ang dahilan yan is how you allocate into different asset classes. Okay.
That's right.
Now,
that's
right. So, kaya important na tama yan yung pag-allocate mo dahil kahit hindi ka na mag-stock picking, basta tama lang yung pag-allocate mo on those different asset classes, on average, you will get there. Okay. Now, usually, kasi tinitignan natin, may mga different asset classes ka. May cash, meron kang bonds, tapos may equities, tapos possible real estate or even alternative investments. No? So, parang spectrum yan, from less risk to more risk. Okay? Usually, we look at those asset classes and then may allocation ka from, let's say, kunyari, meron kang 5% cash, and then 15% bonds, and then you have 80% equities. Para yan yung allocate. That's an example of an asset allocation. Now, sa naman huhulog yan dun sa risk profile? Eh, since malaki-laki yung equities, dun ka huhulog yan
aggressive.
Dun sa mas aggressive. Uh-huh. Diba?
Uh-huh. Tapos, right.
Tapos, kung tipong mas conservative ka, syempre, mas marami yung risk-free na or like cash and bonds. Sabihin natin 15% cash and then 75 na bonds. So, ilan na yun?
75, 80, 90.
80, 90
ka na.
90 na. Tapos, may 10% 10% equity. Kasi nagbubutal pa ako ng 5.
Balansin na, balansado na.
Tapos, 10% equity. So, ayun naman, mas more of conservative ka. Diba? Dahil ayaw niya ng malikot. Kasi the equities are more volatile, so to speak. Mm-hmm. Yan. So, that's an example of two asset allocation that is both from both ends of the spectrum, from conservative to aggressive.
So lumalabas, Dexter, no? As you go more aggressive, yung share ng stock market or ng equities, whether local or risky asset, no? Whether local or global, mas lumalaki siya in terms of the parang pie, no? In terms of correct. The pie. Tapos habang mas nagiging conservative ka, mas lumilit yung equities or mas lumalaki naman yung ano, yung mga conservative instruments like bonds, money market, mga ganyan.
Correct, correct. That's one simplistic way of looking at it. And the mention mo na rin, Zio, about may it be local or global, di ba? Minsan kasi, ang usual perspective is that, uy, dapat mataas yung risk appetite mo to be invested globally. Well, that is the usual misconception.
Yeah, oh, oh, it's not necessarily... kasi mas risky daw yung global eh, no? Ganun yung ano.
Which is not the case. Parang siguro kung Amerikano tayo or let's say from Europe tayo, from Europe venturing into Asia, yes, that is more risky. Pero from an Asian perspective, diversifying into more developed markets, you're actually reducing risk dahil you're from coming from a more risky region to a less risky region. But point go is that when we look at asset allocation, we should go beyond just local assets, but rather also global assets. Dahil, that's the only way that we can really maximize yung possible return mo na hindi ka lalabas dun sa risk appetite mo. If I may elaborate on that, karamihan sa mga Pilipino is that na-force sila, oh sige, 100% equities na ako kasi gusto kong ma-reach yung 8 to 10% return. Okay. Mm-hmm. And kasi tinitingnan lang nila is local equities. Pero kung babalikan natin yung last discussion natin, last episode, di ba? If you go global and then you get to experience and be invested into other markets that will give you that positive return while locally it's a negative return. By on average, tumataas yung average return mo, di ba? And that means you don't really have to go 100% equities, pwedeng a good mix of bonds and stocks ka, pero hindi ka lang local, may global ka rin. And still, you are still properly allocated amongst the different asset classes, pero you're not going beyond your risk profile, yet you are maximizing or itong tinatawag nating optimizing yung return mo. Medyo na pa, napag-ganon si Dede. No? Di ba kapag magdadrive ka, kapag nasa T-plex ka, maganda yung daan, tapos maganda yung takbo mo na constant ka lang, 80 to 100 kilometers per hour, ang mileage mo or yung kilometers per liter consumption mo is high, di ba? Parang ganyan yung ano, yung optimizing. Maximize mo yung return mo, tapos konti lang yung konsumo mo ng risk.
Para sa akin, no, sa isang sanay sa local investments, bago sa akin na perspective yung sinabi ni Dexter na, oo nga, no, we are in an emerging economy, which means if you invest globally in a more stable economy, basically you're investing in a lower risk or you're diversifying your portfolio towards a lower risk type of economy, no, na mas pwedeng makatulong sa'yo na maabot yung goal mo. And of course, sa dami ng mga available na investment, sa dami ng mga available na options, mahirap pa rin na mamili kung aasa ka lang din sa sarili mong research, no? And I guess dito din papasok, Dexter, yung mga AXA financial partners or financial advisors ninyo. So, yes. Kunwari, pag may nakausap, may kinontak akong AXA financial partner, kaya ba niya na tulungan ako na, alam mo yun, i-assess yung risk profile ko, tingnan ko ano dapat yung asset allocation ko, etc. Yes. Is that something that you can offer as a service?
Yes. So, we always encourage our clients or prospective clients to go through our F&A or financial needs analysis. When we do that financial needs analysis, aside from asking kung ano yung risk appetite mo, tinitignan din yun yung situation mo. And from there, we can recommend a set of products that is catered to your needs. Na minsan naman kasi ang challenge kapag tipong masyadong customized or masyadong free for all yung way ng pag-a-assess ng FE is that pwedeng hindi talaga naka-capture properly yung ano needs mo. No? So we do have that. And part of that financial needs analysis is the risk profiling. So there's that set of questions that you would be asked In our case, it's around 7 questions, and that will now give you a certain risk profile. So based on your answers, you have a certain risk profile. And we have what we call a model portfolio, which means...
model portfolio.
This the risk profile mo. May kaakibat yan na allocation between stocks, bonds, cash, and equity, and even global equities. And we do encourage when you get to talk to a financial AXA financial advisor, go through that financial needs analysis.
So ang maganda pa dyan, katulad ng sinabi mo kanina, Dexter, no, yung nagdi-design ka ng portfolio, 70% sa stocks, tapos 20% sa bonds, etc. With investing sa mga AXA funds, meron na kayong tamang allocation, 'di ba? Meron na kayo, sabi mo, may model portfolio kayo. And iba't ibang portfolio ninyo, iba-ibang mix, and then of course the AXA financial advisor can tell you na based on your FNA or financial needs analysis, dito ka mas bagay, no, based on your goals, based in your capacity. So I think that's really helpful, especially do sa mga tao na medyo busy or ayaw na mag-research pa, then it's really an advantage para meron kang kausap. And of course, when you talk to a financial advisor, ano siya eh, di ba? Parang long-term relationship siya. Long-term plan. Kasi, isa sa mga laging nakakalimutan din, yung pag-manage ng portfolio natin, hindi yan ginagawa sa umpisa lang. It's something that you regularly do, di ba?
Okay. Kaya, how often ba? How often ba, Dex? If I may ask, how often should I, should I check my portfolio in that regard, or how often should I talk with my AXA my AXA financial partner? Alam naman sa umpisa lang, di ba?
Yes.
So two things siguro yung questions mo is how often do we revisit our asset allocation, di ba? So unang-una ang view ko dyan is that there's what we call a long-term allocation or
strategic asset allocation.
3 to 5 years, you should revisit it, di ba? And then, or pwedeng matrigger rin ng life event. Kung tipong, una, single ka, tapos biglang ngayon, married ka na, tapos with children. So, that's a life event. Or you have to revisit that. But on top of that, we also encourage our customers to at least meet with our financial advisor at least once a year, so that they get to be updated what's happening with their portfolio, and also revisit yung kanilang asset allocation. Angkop pa rin ba? Kasi minsan, depende, kapag gumalaw na yung merkado, medyo iba na yung allocation yan, di ba? So,
That's right. That's right. So, pwedeng pwedeng kada policy anniversary. Let's celebrate the policy anniversary. Right. So, yeah, saka yun nga, sabi mo, Dex, pag gumalaw na yung market, then mag-iba na. Like, for example, before, kung 80-20 ka, kunwari, conservative, no, 80-20, biglang ang ganda ng akit ng stock market. So, sumipa pa akit. So, I would imagine, kung sumipa pa akit yung stock market, hindi ka na 80-20, baka mamaya, nasa 70-30 or 60-40 na yan, di ba? Of which, kapag chinek mo yung portfolio mo, kung yung strategic asset allocation is at 80-20 pa rin, sir, then ang gagawin mo is i-withdraw mo yung 20 na sobra para ilagay mo ulit doon, para bumalik ka pa rin sa 80-20. Yeah. And do that with your AXA financial partner na super trendy, Dexter. Diba?
So, mga ka-Arki, I hope may natutunan kayong bago dito sa video na to. And of course, kung kailangan nyo ng advice or kailangan nyo ng guidance pagdating sa pagpili ng tamang investment based on your situation, circumstance, your goals, and yung mga life plans ninyo. So, there's a AXA financial partner, an AXA financial advisor that can help you. And of course, you can just go to their website sa axa.com.ph/appointments or you can scan the QR code that you see on the screen para makapag-set ng appointment. And a representative from AXA will help you with your financial plan. So, that's it for this episode. Sa next episode, i-discuss naman natin yung investment horizon. So, continuation pa rin siya nitong discussion natin ng choosing the best investment. So far we've discussed yung based on our risk profile and then how much do we invest in each of these instruments. And for the next episode we talk more about yung investment horizon, yung short term, medium term, long term goals, yeah. No? So how do you approach that? Okay, so with that magpapaalam muna kami and thank you mga ka-Arki sa panonood and see you in our next episode. Alright, so bye-bye!
Thank you, Dex. Bye-bye!
Mga ka-Arki, as we learned, global investing may just be the key to reaching your financial goals. But remember to study your options first and work with a trusted financial institution. Reach out to an AXA financial partner today and we will help you create your global investing game plan.